One of the most common automations that we see in the no-code space is the creation of documents from some sort of template. Very often, the information you need to create a document already lives somewhere inside of your database. You have it in a spreadsheet, a database, somewhere that you can control that information, and you need to create a document from that data. Well, that is exactly what I'm going to be covering in this very video. There is a new software, Docs Automator, that has come to my attention, and I can't wait to try it out. I'm going to be doing it here with you on camera for the first time. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. And in this video, we're going to be looking at the new no-code tool, new to us, Docs Automator. Now, before we get into it, I first want to invite you to join me for some free automation training. If you're newer to no-code in general, or if you just need a refresher, automation is the thing that's going to wind up saving you so much of your time. It's going to eliminate the need for you to do all those mundane, repetitive tasks. I've put together an awesome training for you, totally free. You can grab it at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration and learn all the fundamentals of no-code automation. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. I want to encourage you to follow along with me. If you are enjoying the software and you don't yet have accounts to the things that I'm demonstrating here, please consider using our affiliate links. It is a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. Now let's go ahead and hop on into it. I want to start in Airtable. This is where I'm storing my data. Yours does not have to be in Airtable. I'll show you the different options here in a moment, but I use Airtable almost all the time. And so that's where I have mine. So I have three different records here, record 1, 2, 3. I have a first name and a last name, and I also want to store an attachment here, and I'm going to use an attachment field type. Now, again, this is entirely optional. You don't have to do this. I want to store my document somewhere, though, and that's why I'm building this. So now I'm going to flip into Docs Automator, and I have a brand new account. As you see, I have not created a single doc yet, and I want to create my first automation. Now, the first step is just to click here, and I can rename my automation. I can say auto example, and now I'm going to define my data source. Now, here are the different sources for data. Airtable, obviously what I'm using. You can also use ClickUp if you're a fan of ClickUp, or Glide, or NoLoco. This is one of our new favorite front-end tools inside of the no-code space. So lots of options there. And if your choice is not in these top four right here, well then, my friend, you can use the API. This is a little bit more difficult. You have to know a little bit about how APIs work, but you can still generate a document from just about anywhere. So I, as I said, I'm going to be working from Airtable, so I'll make that selection. And if you haven't already connected your Airtable account, a little modal will pop up and ask you to do that. Mine's already connected, as you see here. Now, for the next step, I need to connect my Google account. Now, the interesting thing about Docs Automator is it's going to be using our Google Drive for the template creation. So the template that we store in Google Drive is going to be the thing that all of the new documents are automated from. And so I need to first select this and pop into my Google Drive. So because this is my first time selecting and connecting with my Google Drive, I get this new modal to pop up here. I simply select the Google Drive that I want to be using, and I am sure to give it the right permissions. And once I'm happy with that, I continue throughout. All right, now I'm synced up with Google Drive that quickly, that easily, and it's asking me to select a template. Now, if I pop this open, it's going to show me all the different templates that I have available to me, all the different documents in my Google Drive. Well, I haven't actually created this document yet, so let's pause and rewind just a little bit, because we need to actually go into Google Drive so that I can create this template that I want to use. Now, since we don't have our template, let's first go and check out the different resources available to us. So Docs Automator has already created a template gallery. You can find it at their website /templates. And here you can just copy the different templates that they've made available for us. So you've got meeting notes, time tracking, purchase orders, credit notes. I guess these are the common different documents that they see that their different clients using. Of course, at the top, we're going to see the most popular ones: invoice, a pro forma invoice, and a project proposal. Not surprising. So I can copy any one of these, but I also want to highlight that inside outside of Docs Automator, they have their own service that will charge money for them to create your document for you. They'll build your template. It's not terribly expensive. I was examining this earlier, and I think it was right around 100 euros. Yeah, here we go. $99 with a money-back guarantee, and they will go ahead and create that template for you. So how cool is that? If you don't want to spend time actually building it, that's a very affordable option for most businesses. So again, for our example, I'm going to pull that project proposal. Let's copy this template and let's see where this takes me. It's taking me to Google Docs. I can make a copy of this and I am going to make sure that it is in my account here, and it's called Copy of Project Proposal. It looks like it's that simple. I believe I should be good to go now. Now, one thing I want to highlight for you is that the different documents that we create, they're going to have unique data each time we go to create a new one. And so we're going to create a different document for every record that we have in Airtable. I have three different records, and we can build automation to create all of those documents. Now, the way that Docs Automator knows what data to pull in is it has these squiggly brackets. So the double squiggly bracket here is the indication that, hey, this little piece right here, this is a variable. And every time we create a document, it's going to be different. It's going to use new dynamic information that came from whatever our source data was. But there are other parts of the document that will not change. So here I've got Automation Mania Inc. You can see there are no squiggly brackets here. This is going to be static information, static data. It will not change from one to the next. Now, for our example, I don't have this many different fields. I just had a first name and a last name. So I'm going to go ahead and remove all of the other things that we have here. All of these other variables that I don't have data for, let's just pull them so that we don't have any confusion here. And so I've got this, all of this static data here, and I have a project title, which I'm going to get rid of. I do want to highlight also that the font and the different textual elements, so the size of the font, the bold, underlines, all of those components, those are going to be translated into our final document. So you can see here that if I were to change this, let's say I've got first name here, I'll do first underscore name, and then this one down here, I will make last name. And I will make them different. So I will change this one, let's say, to be much larger, and I will italicize it, whereas the first one here is just emboldened. So I will actually remove the bold from this one as well so that we can see this in action. So this top one is bold and smaller, and the bottom one, the last name, is italicized, not bold text, and much larger in font size. So we're going to see that translate as we get through here. But let's go back now to Docs Automator and remember the name of the template that we just created. Mind you, we did this in a matter of seconds. It's called Copy of Project Proposal. Back now to my Docs Automator, and I am going to find it here. So I've got Copy of Project Proposal. Here it is right here. Let's go ahead and make that selection, and now that's it. So now that I've made that selection, our document should be talking, but we see that we're getting a warning that says the template can't be loaded because we don't have the right permissions. So let's actually flip back in here and make sure that we've enabled the sharing. So the fact that we've made this private only to ourselves is kind of breaking this up right now. And so what we need to do is go down to general access and say anyone with the link can actually work on this. And I'm going to give them editor permissions. I don't know that I need editor, but I'm going to unlock all the permissions just to make sure that everything is rocking and rolling. So let's head back to Docs Automator now, and we're going to try this one more time. And again, I'm going to look up Project Proposal, and it was called Copy of Project Proposal. Here it is. And now I see that I am all synced up. So I've connected to the Project Proposal template that I'm working with. Now, I did run into a bit of a snag here off camera. I had to refresh this page. So if you continue to get that little red warning sign that says, hey, things aren't connecting, try refreshing your page. It seemed to work for me, and now I'm able to pull this information in. So first and foremost, we're going to look at the settings here. So yes, I'm in the United States. How do I want to format numbers? So it's pretty cool. I mean, that we can change all of this right here, and also our date time format if we want to go with one digit or two for the days. And then again, we get a bunch of choices for month. How we want to show that information, it's going to be displayed right here as an example. And also, do we want to save the doc? So if this is checked, Docs Automator is going to generate in a Google Doc in addition to the PDF. Now, I don't need that. I just want the PDF. And so that's all I need. I'll keep this unchecked. But if you want to create a new Google Doc every time, just check this box and it's going to be created along with the PDF. Now, we also have an expiration here, so we can subscribe, that is, get on a paid plan to save our PDFs inside of Doc Automator's storage. So that's not something I need. I'm going to send it on back to Airtable, so I don't think I need to subscribe on this account just yet, although full transparency, I'm sure I will be subscribing and upgrading this account soon. Now, we also have some options here in terms of the quality of the image, the max width, and then if we're going to overwrite the attachment field. So in this particular case, Docs Automator will overwrite the attachment field with a newly generated PDF. If it's unchecked, then the PDF that's created will be added as a new attachment. So if you want to be able to have an automation that says, I only want to ever have one document here, then you're going to want to make sure to check this box. If not, it's just going to keep adding new documents every time you create a new one. All right, so that's pretty much it for the settings here. Now for the next part, we're coming down to mapping the Airtable data. So first we have to choose the base that we're pulling this information from. So my base, as you can see, I've got quite a lot here. I'm going to look for Docs Automator. And here it is. That's the name of the database that I'm using for my example. And I only have one table here. Again, if I were to flip back here, you're going to see exactly that. Here's the base name, Docs Automator, and here's the table, table one. All right, so back into our setup here. What is the document name? Well, I'm going to go with the record ID, but I can have access to all the different fields inside of that table, right? I've got the record ID, I've got the first name and the last name. If I hover over here, it's saying, you know, you're going to select a field from the table that will be used to name the new document. Okay. Now also the attachment field, where are you going to be saving this document after you've automatically created it? I'm using the attachment field here and we're good to go. Now we see that we have to map our fields as the next step. We're mapping the corresponding fields from the Google Doc to the fields in Airtable. And a lot of these I thought we got rid of, but maybe we didn't save the actual Google Doc in time. And so it's not really sure that that's happened. Now I want to point out for this template, there were actually three total pages. And if you don't remove all of those additional variables, then you can't proceed in the creation of your automation. So you have to make sure that all of your variables are mapped to data. And if they are not, then you're going to run into a bit of a snag. So let's go ahead and flip back now into the Docs Automator. And you'll see that the last component here is mapping those fields. So this is the variable here, first_name, that lives in my template. And I mapped it to the field in Airtable. So I'm pulling the data from Airtable and I'm plugging it into the template every time I perform the automation. Same thing with last_name. Well, that's the last name field in Airtable. Now, I also want to point out that Docs Automator will allow you to go with linked records. So if you need to create an invoice and you have line items or other linked relationships inside of your data, you can actually perform that very function with Docs Automator, all with a simple automation and an amazing template. So you'll see that over here on the side, we get a little preview of what our document is going to look like. And for this particular case, it's Minnie Mouse. That's record two. I can change this to record one and generate a preview here. And we're going to see the same thing, except this time it'll be updated for Mickey. Right? Give it a second to think. And this allows us to make sure that we've mapped everything appropriately and that it all looks right. So once we're happy with this, it's time to put together our automation. And we have three different options that are coming from Docs Automator. We have the option for an automation script. We have the scripting extension. And then lastly, we have a webhook. Now for me, I'm going to use the automation script. I feel like it's the most seamless. And I want to highlight for you that all of the information you need is already written into your script. So it has your API key, it has your document ID, all of the different components have been automatically generated for you. Now, of course, for our example, I'm going to have to keep my API key blurred out, but just know that yours will be filled out appropriately when you are using this method. So I'm going to click this to my clipboard so that I can use it in my very automation. But now I'm going to head on into Airtable and I want to set up the conditions that will allow me to start my automation. Now, back on the back end, I've added a new field called single select. And the idea is when I say go, that is going to then run the automation. So I'm going to build my automation condition. The trigger condition is looking for that single select field. So here we are. I'm going to add a trigger that looks for that very field in table one. And I'm looking for the status, the single select status, to be go. So when that occurs, that will trigger the automation, and we're going to choose a record. Here's an example. Great. Now I'm going to run a script. So in my script, all I have to do is paste the script that I got from Docs Automator. Again, I'm going to keep my API key blurred out here, but you get the idea. This very script, simple to use. Now, the only thing I need to update is this variable called rec ID. So right now I haven't mapped a variable here and I need to add an input variable. Make sure to name it exactly the same. And when you do that, you'll see that red squiggly line disappears from here because I've now identified the proper variable. And what I want to pass in, the value, is going to be the actual Airtable record ID. Just like that. So easy. I can run a test here, and this is going to then send that information as a test over to Docs Automator. Let's make sure that we get that successful output that we're looking for and hang out here while that performs in the background. All right, so I got the success message from console.log. Everything looks good, so I should be up and running. I'm going to click on finish editing. Now, the last piece I want to add to my automation, I want to update the record that started this. Again, that was in table one. And what I want to update here is going to be the very field that started the automation. So that single select field, I want it to be complete. So when I mark it to go, that will trigger the automation to run. It's going to run and create the document. And then I want to make it say complete. All right, so let's go ahead and turn this automation on now and flip on back to Airtable. Now, I want to point out for you that when we ran that test, we created this document. And it's been named with record one. If, as I hover over here, you see that that is what it's called. So let's run a test here. I am going to click on go, and that will trigger our automation in the background. Remember, Airtable is going to run that script, send the information to Docs Automator, create the document, automatically upload it back here as you just saw, and then it's going to update us to complete, all in one fell swoop. And so if I were to flip back into Docs Automator, now that we're done with this whole setup, let's go back to our dashboard. In fact, I'll just refresh here to see how many different times we've created docs. So here we go. We see we're on the free plan. We have a maximum of 50 different documents. We can see our example right here is taking this from Airtable, running and creating the automation here, the automated document, and generating it into a PDF. And it looks like everything is working appropriately. Everything is set up correctly. And so the last component here is to go and explore the pricing on side of Docs Automator. So if we look at the subscription plans, let's actually take a look. I'm going to go monthly here. And we see that there are three different options. If I were to go with Docs Automator 200, I get 200 docs per month at €15 per month. I can double that in terms of price, go up to €29 per month and get 500. And then lastly, they have a plan for 2,000 automation documents every month. So a lot of different options. No matter how many documents you are looking to create, there is a plan here for you that is going to work within your budget. So that's it for this video. I encourage you to give Docs Automator a try and let me know in the comments below what your thoughts about it are. I personally love the fact that we can get so simple. I mean, this whole thing came together in a matter of minutes, all from a nice integration with Docs Automator, Google Drive, and Airtable. Drop any questions you have below, but in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.